Praise the Lord. Greetings to you in the wonderful name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. We thank God for those who have managed to be back again, like we said on Tuesday, that we are going to wind up, we are going to finish our message concerning the squeeze. Amen. So today we'll also touch a little bit on the image of the beast. We touched it on Tuesday. We all know that the image of the beast is going to squeeze the bride of the Lord Jesus Christ. So we just want to go quickly at Revelation chapter 13. Let's just read Revelation chapter 13. We really appreciate God for these things. Hallelujah. So Revelation chapter 13, he says, "And I stood upon the sand of the sea, and I saw a beast rise up out of the sea, having seven heads and seven horns, and upon his horns 10 crowns, and upon his heads the name of blasphemy. And the beast which I saw was like unto a leopard, and his feet were as it were the feet of a bear, and his mouth as the mouth of a lion, and the dragon gave him power," his power, "and his seat and great authority." Amen. And then we rush again, we jump at the scriptures, and we arrive here. And then he says here, we want to see where we should read again, and say, verse 11, "And I beheld another beast coming out of the earth, and he had two horns like a lamb, and he spake as a dragon." Amen. "And he exercised all the power of the first beast before him, and caused the earth and them which dwell therein to worship," amen, "the first beast, whose deadly wound was healed." Amen. "And he doeth great wonders, so that he maketh fire," amen, "come down from heaven on the earth in the sight of men." Hey, 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 hey. "And he deceiveth them that dwelleth on the earth by the means of those miracles which he had power to do in the sight of the beast," amen, "saying to them that dwell on the earth that they should make an image to the beast which he had the wound by a sword, and he did live. And he had power to give life unto the image of the beast, that the image of the beast should both speak and cause that as many as would not worship in the image of the beast should be killed. And he caused all, small and great, rich and poor, free and bond, to receive a mark in the right hand or in their foreheads, and that no man might buy or sell, save he that had the mark or the name of the beast or the name of his name. Here is wisdom. Amen. Let him that hath understanding count the number of the beast, for it is the number of a man, and his number is 666. Amen. So we really thank God for these things. Amen. Praise God. We really appreciate. So we just want to wrap up our message upon the squeeze. Amen. So we believe God is here. God is going to talk to us. So I just want to read as we go quickly here and see what the prophet says. Amen. Praise be to God. And then he says here in the message, conferences. Amen. He says, "The time is coming when you are either going to put your organization into the World Council of Churches." So do you see what Brother Branham is saying here? We read a lot of quotations on Tuesday about the boycott, about the squeeze. So we just want to proceed and finish our message. We thank God, hallelujah, that the squeeze is not, but the squeeze is things that are to be. Hallelujah, the squeeze shall come. So this lockdown, this what is happening, the corona pandemic, it is only, Hallelujah. Some rehearsals. Hallelujah. It's only God that is giving us the opportunity to exercise our faith. Hallelujah. So that when we get now into the real squeeze, we will be having power. We will be really trained for that. Hallelujah. Praise God. So he says the time is coming when you are either going to put your organization into the World Council of Churches. Amen. And then he says, you take that, he says, if you do that. So do you see, my friend, my brother, my sister, if you put your organization into the World Council of Churches, you will, if you do that, you take the image of the beast. Hallelujah. Praise God. Cause you got a power, just like it was in Rome. And if you don't do it, you will be an individual. Hallelujah. Independent church. And when you do, the image of the beast is going to close your doors. Amen. And you are going to be forbidden. So, brother, I'm talking about the boycott. I'm talking about the squeeze. Amen. So, brother Branham says, if you refuse to join the World Council of Churches, how many can say amen? Yeah? You will be an individual. Hallelujah. An independent church. Hallelujah. So, during the time of the squeeze, we are going to refuse to join the World Council of Churches. Why? Because we are independent from all these evil spirits. Hallelujah. And then he says here, if you don't do it, you will be an independent church. And when you do, when you refuse, the image of the beast is going to close your doors. Hallelujah. And you are going to be forbidden. And then you are going to need a conference. See, do you see, my brother, my sister, that this is the squeeze, this is the boycott. So for us, because you remember when we said on Tuesday that when you join the World Council of Churches, you are forfeiting, hallelujah, your evangelistical rights. You are forfeiting the baptism of the Holy Spirit. You are forfeiting the doctrine of the Bible. You are selling your birthright. Do you understand now? So, but now we are going to refuse to join the World Council of Churches. We are going to be independent. Hallelujah. So when we are independent like that, our churches are going to be closed. Our doors are going to be closed. Hallelujah. We are going to be forbidden. Amen. And then he says here, they tell us that we cannot, no longer, we can't preach in the name of Jesus. Let's consult God and find out whether we can or not. So they went up and they had a conference. And then he says, Oh, excuse me. We need one that this morning, one like that this morning. Is that, he says, is it good for us to obey men or God? Said the apostle. They had a conference about what we got this morning. And they stood up and give. The church is telling us we can't preach unless we come to their group and so forth. And he says, and we can't have this minister less the organization says so. And no matter how much anointed it is, we have to do this, that. And you know how it is, each group and so forth. What are we going to do? So, brother, do you see that it was practically that way, even in the days of the prophet, even in our days, it's practically that way. We are seeing that the squeeze is building up, hallelujah, to culminate into this great squeeze, hallelujah. So it's happening, praise God, but it will come now, where it will culminate, where our churches are going to be closed. So now we are just seeing what is happening during this lockdown. This is just a foretaste of the squeeze. The squeeze is not yet come. But this is just a foretaste. It's God that is showing us that this is possible. Hallelujah. Amen. And then we say here, we want to see what Brother Branham says again. Hallelujah. Amen. The third Exodus. I believe God is going to bless us. 6306 30M. He says paragraph 108. She appears in Revelation 13. This is America now. She appears in Revelation 13, number 13, and remember, it raised up like a lamp, freedom of religion, but it received a power from the beast, an image like it. And he spoke with all the authority. We have read this, and done the same rotten things the beast did before him. Then he says, then tell me, it's not prophesied of this nation. The Amorite condition is just about tribe, because they are already working in it. Amen. Praise be to God. How many are understanding this? And even our new Pope, his main purpose, this is 63, his main purpose is to unite the brethren together. And to the natural eye, it's the thing to do. But in the eyes of God, it's contrary to the Holy Spirit. We can't mix up with that. Amen. And then he says, and every church will be called into that federation. He says, now watch now. He says, get out of that thing as quick as you can. You will take the mark of the beast, not knowing what you are doing. Get out of it. Do you hear Malachi 4? The prophet messenger. Hallelujah. He's saying, get out of that thing as quick as you can. You will take the mark of the beast, not knowing what you are doing. Get out of it. So do you remember even the prophet when we spoke about the three curtains? He says there is a bamboo curtain, which is red China. He says there is the iron curtain, which is Russia, and the purple curtain. So the prophet says the bamboo curtain, which is China, and the iron curtain, which is Russia, they are horrible. But he was always saying, watch. Watch the purple curtain. The prophet, in many scriptures and in many quotations, he spoke about, watch the purple curtain. Watch the purple curtain. The rise of the Roman Catholic in the United States and all over. How many understand that? So the purple curtain, which the prophet says, it is the most cruelest. And you remember the prophet says, Rome will rule the world for 1 hour. So he says, Rome will rule the world for a piece of time. That's what he was saying. So it means during that time of the squeeze, Rome will be ruling. Are we together? Amen. So he's telling us, watch that purple curtain. Amen. Watch Rome. How many can say amen? So we understand these things. So we just want to move again. Amen. So that we see what the prophet says. Hallelujah. Praise God. I believe we read again the 10 virgins. Hallelujah. Praise God. The 10 virgins and 144,000 Jews, 60, 12, 11. He says, the image of the beast, the Protestant denomination. So what is the image? He says, the image of the beast, the Protestant denomination, not the Catholic. This is America. He is speaking of here. Do you hear what Brother Branham is saying? The image of the beast, the Protestant denomination, not the Catholic. This is America. He is speaking of here. You see, because this 13th chapter is on the American, the beast that come out. He says now all the other beasts come out of water, which means thickness and multitudes of people. But the beast here, it come up like a lamb out of the ground where there was no people, and two horns, and then it spoke like a dragon, and they made an image of the beast that was in Europe. So do you see that the beast is in Europe, in the Vatican? So, but they made an image, and then he says, and made this over here an image too. Uniting the churches together and making this Protestant fellowship. And then they forced all the other churches that they don't even buy or sell or anything else without they got this image of the beast. How many understand this? That you see that there's two beasts. Hallelujah. Praise God. You remember that mighty angel that came down. He put his right hand on the foot or on the sea. And his other foot, he put one foot on the sea and another foot on the land. And we know that the sea, hallelujah, the beast, the other beast come from the sea. And the other beast come from the land. So which is the beast which came from the sea? Which is Rome? Which is the Catholic? And the beast which came from the land? The prophet is showing us. It appears in Revelation chapter 13. It's America. So, but do you see now, hallelujah, that this message of the hour is so powerful. How many can say amen? We can overcome. How many can say amen? All these things we can fight and overcome because the mighty angel, he came down, hallelujah, and put one foot on the beast on the sea and one foot on the land to show that these two beasts, how many can say amen, they were overcome. How many can say amen? By the mighty angel, by Jesus Christ himself. Amen. So it shows us, praise God, yes, we admit that these beasts have got power, but the Spirit of God and the power of God is more than the power of the beast. And you remember, even right now as we speak, Brother Branham tells us that watch Russia, watch Russia. You remember the seven major visions. There is a vision where Brother Branham says, watch Russia, the king of the north. And the prophet tells us that Russia is going to drop one bomb on the Vatican and one bomb in America. How many can say amen? So we believe, hallelujah, that modern events are made clear by prophecy. So we thank God for our prophet in this end time, that is God's seer, is God's eye, is God's mouthpiece. He has showed us these things. So we thank God that without the prophet, we could not have understood these things. We appreciate God even for Malachi 4. Hallelujah. Who has come, hallelujah, in this end time to make these things clearer. How many can say amen? Because he says, in the days of the voice of the seventh angel, when he shall begin to sound, the mystery of God should be finished, as he hath declared unto his servants, the prophets. So Brother Branham says, what is a mystery? He says, a mystery is a scripture that has been previously hidden, but has been divinely revealed, but which still remains a supernatural element despite the revelation. How many can say amen? And the prophet says, if you want to understand the mysteries, if you want to understand scripture or a mystery, Brother Branham says, it takes one with prophetic insight. It takes the ability to hear from God. It takes supernatural instruction. Not a student comparing verse with verse, though it is good, but it takes, hallelujah, the ability to hear from God. It takes supernatural instruction. It takes, how many can say amen, prophetic insight. Hallelujah. I believe that tonight I'm preaching to someone. I'm preaching to people with the ability to hear from God. I'm speaking to people with supernatural instruction. Hallelujah. Praise God. How many can say amen? The ability to hear from God is supernatural instruction. Amen. Prophetic insight. How many can say amen? We thank God for these things. Hallelujah. Praise God. The prophet is a divine interpreter of the word. Hallelujah. We thank God that Malachi 4 has come. Revelation chapter 10 has come. We believe, hallelujah, that who is William Branham? William Branham is Revelation 10:7 manifested. Luke 17:30 manifested. Amos chapter 3 manifested. We really appreciate God. Amen. Praise God. So the prophet says, they that receive the prophet in the name of the prophet shall receive the beneficent effects. Oh, I like that. The beneficent effects of the prophet's ministry. How many can say amen? We are here to receive the beneficent effects of the prophet's ministry. He that receiveth the prophet in the name of a prophet shall receive, hallelujah, the reward, the prophet's reward. And what is that? Is to be a friend of the prophet. And if you are a friend of the prophet, friends, the main characteristics of friendship is secrets. How many can say amen? A friend will always share secrets with you. How many can say amen? That's the reason why Esther, are we together? Praise God. Why Esther was received by Ahasuerus. Why? You remember when Vashti was chased away and there was a big thing that happened where they were looking for the replacement of Vashti. There were many damsels that were there. So when they came trying to please Ahasuerus, they were chucked out. Why? Others came with mini skirts, others came with painted faces, others came with trousers and all things. And Ahasuerus was not interested in that. But why did Esther, why did King Ahasuerus receive Esther? How many can say amen? Why did King Ahasuerus receive Esther? I would like to believe that there was a chamberlain that was close to Esther. How many can say amen? So that chamberlain, who was now, he was also close to King Ahasuerus. How many can say amen? So that chamberlain who was close to King Ahasuerus would come. That chamberlain knew the mind of King Ahasuerus. He knew what Ahasuerus liked. And he came, he was giving Esther the tips. And said, if you want to be received, how many can say amen, by King Ahasuerus, you must dress in modest apparel. You must have shamefacedness. You must do this and this and that. Don't put paints and all these things. How many can say amen? And Esther, hallelujah, receiving the mind of Ahasuerus through the chamberlain. When he came now before the Ahasuerus, she was received. Why? Because she was close to someone who was close to the chamberlain, who was close to God. And in this end time, we are waiting for the rapture. All of us, there are many churches, hallelujah, but Jesus is coming to take a bride without spot or wrinkle. How many can say amen? But you and me, we are privileged, because even the Pentecostals, they are here also. They also want to be received by this Jesus Christ, our Ahasuerus. But we thank God for our chamberlain, hallelujah, William Branham, that came, praise God, in another spoken word. What did he say? Christ is the mystery of God revealed. My brother, my sister, he never said Jesus is the mystery. I want you to see, because Jesus is the body, but Christ is the anointing. Christ is the Logos. So you must know that the Logos, Christ, was in Jesus. So Jesus was the body that was in Christ. That's why he says Christ is the mystery of God revealed. How many can say amen? So in that spoken word, Christ is the mystery of God revealed. He says, God had a threefold purpose. He says, today, I want to tell you what was in the back part of God's mind. Can't you see our chamberlain, William Branham? Amen. Praise God. Who knew God's mind? Who knew what God wanted? That's what he has told us. So it's not tough. It's easy for us to make it in the rapture. How many can say amen? Because we are following a chamberlain who knows what the Lord Jesus Christ wants. Praise God. So I just want to quickly go. We thank God for our prophet, hallelujah, William Branham, who is our chamberlain. Amen. Do you love him? Are you enjoying? Hallelujah. So he says here, praise God, hallelujah, amen. He's saying now, and they made an image of the beast that was in Europe, and made this over here an image too. And then he says now, uniting the churches together and making this Protestant fellowship. And then they forced all the other churches that they couldn't even buy or sell or anything else without, he says, without they got this image for the beast. Amen. Praise God. I really appreciate God for all these things. And then he says in the message that the Ethiopian church age, we just want to rush again. He says, help us, oh Lord, to be ready to stand now. Then he says, because the time is closing in, as we see this two-horned beast rise up out of the earth. So do you see that the beast that rose from the earth is America, and the beast that rose from the sea is the what? Is the Catholic, the beast. So do you see now that this beast, hallelujah, Rome, is the one that is giving power even to America, is giving power to the image of the beast. So you see that he started so simple, he started so humble, freedom of religion. But I'm telling you, brother, in the squeeze, you are going to see this beast. How many can say amen? With two horns, it will exercise the same power. How many can say amen? Oh, my Father, my God, I really appreciate these things. There are many things that are coming up. Hallelujah. So let's continue here. And then he says, now, he says, with horns like a lamb, but it speaks like the dragon. We believe that the hour is close at hand. He says, Father, when these churches is confederating themselves together, making an image unto the beast, and it will be terrible on that group. Do you see, my brother, my sister? It will be terrible on that group, Lord, that won't join. Brother, I want you to see the squeeze. That's why I'm talking about the squeeze. It will be terrible. How many can say amen? Huh? So they are going to terrorize us. They are going to squeeze us. But I want to show you, my brother, my sister, that is, like I told you, that Ramses was being trained to take over. How many can say amen? And in the wilderness, Moses was also being trained too. Hallelujah, for this showdown. So I'm telling you that this now is coming now to a showdown. We are not afraid. How many can say amen? You are going to see why I'm talking like this. Hallelujah. Don't worry, little frogs. We have the power. So some of you people, you think that you don't have the power. You think that you don't have anything. Let me tell you, my brother, my sister, when you are put in a corner, when you are squeezed, that's when your true colors come. If you want to see who we are, if you want to see who a Christian is, you squeeze him, you put him in a temptation. That's when, brother, you see his true colors. How many can say amen? Every time a true Christian, he overcomes. Hallelujah. So we thank God that even in the squeeze, when we are squeezed, when it is going to be terrible to us, how many can say amen? We are going to overcome. You are going to see why I'm saying this. Don't be afraid. Hallelujah. We are going to become the word, because the Bible says you grow on what you feed on. Do you believe what I'm saying? In the beginning was the word, and the word was with God, and the word was God. So this word that we are saying amen to, this word that we are receiving, remember, Brother Branham says, you are as strong as the amount of the word that is in you. So even right now, we must really feast upon the word. We must really listen to the tapes, listen to the fivefold ministry, as God is training us for that showdown in the squeeze. Brother, this is going to happen, and it's later than we think. So this lockdown, this corona pandemic, is the time to just flex our muscles. It's the time just to exercise our faith. How many can say amen? We have the power in the name of Jesus Christ. Those certain rages, we cannot be defeated. I'm telling you, my brother, we must exercise the third bull faith. Even now, we must speak in the revelation of our faith. How many can say amen? They are God-trained men. Hey, God-trained men, brother, they are trained in a rugged way. Some through the fire, some through the flood, but all through the blood. So right now, hallelujah, we are being trained for the squeeze, for the greatest battle that is going to come. I'm enjoying. Hallelujah. We are not afraid for the squeeze. We are actually waiting for it. When you see the soldiers training, hallelujah. When you see people who play soccer, they train, hallelujah, before the real match. How many can say amen? So even this lockdown, this coronavirus, all these problems, we are just training. Hallelujah. We are just preparing. Praise God. Amen. That's why you see even North Korea, you see America, you see these superpowers, they are dropping, hallelujah, testing their atomic bombs in the oceans, in the seas. So my brother, my sister, we also want to test, hallelujah, our third pool power in this corona pandemic. We want to test our third pool power. How many can say amen in this lockdown, so that we just speak the food into existence. We speak a live chicken into existence. We speak mealy-meal into existence, and we enjoy. How many can say amen? Even William Branham, he did it. How many can say amen? He says, I want a squirrel there, and it was there. I want another. He thought he was dreaming. My brother, my sister, hallelujah, we have the power in the name of Jesus Christ. So I believe, hallelujah, that God has given us this lockdown as an opportunity, hallelujah, to bring out what is in us. Hallelujah. But that thing that is in us, which we are manifesting now in the lockdown, will come into full operation during the squeeze. Hallelujah. Amen. So how many have been blessed? We really appreciate. Amen. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hey, so you see that these things is going to be terrible. Hallelujah. Very terrible. Very terrible to the people that are not there. So may God help us. Amen. So we just finish this, making an image unto the beast, and it will be terrible on that group, Lord, that won't join. The very boycott will come. But in that hour, you promise to take your church. How many can say amen? Help us, Lord. So I want to show you something. Hallelujah. That there are going to be events that are going to happen here. Listen to this. Before one drop of water fell, Noah was in the ark. Do you see, my brother, my sister? Before one drop of water fell, Noah was in the ark. Before the fire could strike Sodom, Lot was gone. Father, we believe before the atomic powers ever blow this earth to pieces, the church will be gone. We are so glad, Lord, and we know that the bombs are hanging in the hangers tonight. So do you see the other thing here? That just right in the squeeze there, where we are going to exercise our power, where we are going to be. So many things, the prophet says, events are going to transpire very rapidly. So even in the squeeze, where we are going to speak the word, where we are going to create the food, because we won't be allowed. Because someone will be asking, brother, when we are not allowed to buy or sell, how are we going to survive? Let me tell you, that's why I said, today I want to wrap up my message. How many can say amen? So we are not going to be those who did not join the World Council of Churches, those without the mark, they are not going to be allowed to buy or sell. So it is us that will be targeted. So we won't be allowed even to buy or even to sell. So it means, I want to show you, brother, do you see that this lockdown, it's better than what is going to happen in the squeeze? Because the lockdown, you only need your money. You don't need the mark of the beast or anything, or the mark or whatever, for you to buy food. So it is easy. That's why I read the scripture that says, if you run with footmen and they weary thee, how can you contend with horses? So even right now, when things are tough for you, hallelujah, in this lockdown, how are you going to do in the swelling of Jordan? How can you contend with horses? So it means this lockdown is just footmen. It's just easy. How many can say amen? So any brother and sister, can you say amen? Can you say, this is food to us. This is bread to us. How many can say, like Joshua and Caleb, that we are more than able, hallelujah, to win the battle of the coronavirus? We are more than able to overcome in the lockdown. We want to come out of the lockdown more fatter. Hallelujah. Having gained more kgs, more weight. How many can say amen? Because we are too strong. Hallelujah. The promise is too... Let me tell you, my brother, my sister. Hallelujah. Your position is too big. Your position is greater than your circumstance. Our position is greater. How many can say amen? Hallelujah. The word of God will defeat Satan anytime, any place, anywhere. So we are using the same word. How many can say amen? To overcome in this time of the lockdown. Those who are listening to me, those who are running out of food, those who are running out of mealie-meal, those who are running out of sustenance, of provision, I want to tell you, my brother, my sister, the Lord God shall provide. I speak like a son of Abraham, because when Abraham was asked, he said, my son, the Lord shall provide himself a sacrifice. Bride of Jesus, the Lord himself shall provide for your food, shall provide for everything that you need. Fear not. How many can say amen? How we thank God. Praise be to God. Hallelujah. Amen. So let's continue. We thank God we are moving so well today. And then the prophet says, questions and answers here, 59:06-8. He says on paragraph 128, and now that church was taken up, and the remnant of the woman's seed who keep the commandments of God and faith and have faith in Jesus Christ. See, not the bride, the remnant of the woman's seed. Then the dragon spouted out water out of his mouth to make war with the remnant of the seed. That's when the Protestant church, under the Federation of Churches, which is the image of the beast, which is now being formed. This is 1959. I want you to see. Brother Branham is saying, which is the image of the beast, which is now being formed. And there will be a boycott upon all churches like this. So I'm telling you, my brother, my sister, we cannot continue pushing these things far. Hallelujah. The hour is fast spent. It's later than we think. It's 3 minutes before midnight. We want to see now the full blown up squeeze. How many can say amen? Because the prophet in 1959, he says, now, he says, that then when the Protestant church under the Federation of Churches, which is the image of to the beast, which is now being formed. So do you see that the image of the beast was formed in the 50s, 1959, was being formed. And right now as I speak, I want to tell you, my friend, my brother, my sister, that we are there. We are almost there. May God help us. Hallelujah. And then he says, there will be a boycott upon all churches like this. Hallelujah. Praise be to God. So do you see now what we are talking about? So in the message, amen, the handwriting on the wall, I want you to see something also. The handwriting on the wall, 560902. The prophet says, I like the prophet. Hallelujah. How many are being blessed? Amen. He says, and he made it. He forced every person in his kingdom, in his domain, to worship this image. He made an image. And it's believed by scholars, in which I do believe that a spirit-filled person would see it, that he worshipped Daniel. Is what he did, and he made an image to Daniel. Amen. And he called it Belshazzar. And then he says, he called Daniel Belshazzar, which was the name of his God. And he made an image. We are introducing something now. He made an image and forced every person to worship that image. The image of Daniel, the image of Belshazzar. Hallelujah. So do you remember? And let's continue. Paragraph 89. I'm talking handwriting on the wall. 560902. Those who are writing down 89. He says, I want you to notice, my brother, my sister, I also want you to notice, amen, that the beginning of the Gentiles, when God dealt with them, he says they got haughty in their heart and forced every man to worship the image of a holy man. And the Gentile church was issued in with that. So do you see that the Gentile age was issued by a forced worship of images of men? How many can say amen? Let's read and see what he says. It will go out in the same way. Brother, do you see that the Gentile kingdom was, this is strong, friends. The Gentile kingdom was issued in. It started with the worship of images. It started with the squeeze, forcing people to worship images of men. And he says it will also go out the same way. Can't you see, my brother, my sister, that we are in the last days? This is the time where this quotation is going to be fulfilled. Amen. And the Gentile age was issued in with that. Issued in with that, with what? Worshipping of images, forcing people. How many can say amen? Praise God. And then he says, that will force, and then he says, it will go out in the same way. Eh? The same way. Hallelujah. A boycott. So I want to drop this. You know, something is coming. How many can say amen? So listen now. Do you see, my brother, my sister, that there was an image that was put there, and many people, they said, if you don't worship, if you refuse to worship that thing, you are going to die. Eh? Do you believe? But there were many people in Babylon. There were many brethren. But how come only few brethren? How many can say amen? You see, they refused. Only a few brethren, they refused. How many can say amen? Yeah? They stood loyal to the word of God. And others, I would like to believe. How many can say amen? That they worshipped. How many can say amen? And I would believe that Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they refused. How many can say amen? To worship. Oh, hallelujah. We are talking about, how many can say amen? The squeeze. How many can say amen? Do you believe that? Brother, this was a serious hour. I'm talking about the squeeze, the image of the beast. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. Brother, I hope I did not wake up the neighborhood. Listen, this was the time of the water, of the squeeze, where they said everyone must worship the image of Daniel. How many can say amen? But Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they refused to sell their birthright. Are you Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego? They refused to forfeit their evangelistical, hallelujah, doctrine. They refused to forfeit the baptism of the Holy Ghost. They said no ways. And they boiled up, they put up, they set up now a fire. It was terrible. But let me tell you, in Babylon, there were many brothers. How many can say amen? There were many, we can say even say thousands of brothers were there. But how come? Why is it there were only three people, three brothers in the fire, in the fiery furnace? So it means all these other brethren, they sold out. How many can say amen? They were not ready. They chose to stand with an image. How many can say amen? And I pray that history will not repeat. How many can say amen? All things are possible, even unto them that believe. How many can say amen? Do you see, my brother, that only Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego overcame that squeeze? They stood for God in their time. I thank God that I'm one of them. That's why we always sing that, praise God, I'm one of them. Hallelujah. Tell your neighbor and say, I am one of them. Praise God. If it means to get into the fiery furnace. And did you see what happened? When they were in the fiery furnace, the fourth man came down. Hallelujah. To fight for them. So it means also that if we stand for the word of God, the word of God is going to stand with us too. How many are being blessed? Praise God. Oh, God is with us here. I'm enjoying. Hallelujah. Praise God. Are we together? How many are enjoying? How many have seen the type? Hallelujah. Praise God. So let's quickly go here. Amen. Praise God. I'm seeing this. Oh, this is so wonderful. Praise be to God. So, and then he says here, we just finish. Hallelujah. How many are being blessed? Praise God. And then he says here, I want you to notice that the beginning of the Gentile, hallelujah, the Gentiles, when God dealt with them, they got haughty in their heart and forced every man to worship the image of a holy man. How many can say amen? They got haughty in their heart and forced every man to worship the image of the beast. How many can say amen? I really appreciate all things are possible. Everything is fine. Are we together? Hallelujah. We are enjoying. Praise God. And then we continue here. We just want to finish. But I believe that if you are spiritual, God is really talking to you. God is really answering you. So Brother Branham says this is very key. He says the Gentile age was issued in with that, with the squeeze. And then it will go out in the same way. Same way. A boycott of the mark of the beast that will force people to worship images and to do things that we haven't been taught that was contrary to the word of God. And brother, it will be so sleek and sly. Do you see, brother? It will be so sleek. Can you imagine why it was sleek? Because do you know that it was easier for Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego to worship that image? They were going to say, ah, this is our brother. We know him. Let's worship. It was so sleek and sly. How many but they saw it? Because the elect will never be deceived. Hallelujah. And he says, it will deceive the very elect if possible. So you better purpose in your heart tonight and be filled with God's Holy Spirit that you will be able to discern the right and wrong thing when the proclamation is issued. So now I just want to quickly rush. How many can say amen? Are you with me now? Hallelujah. I just want to go. We said we just want to talk a little bit about this image of the beast. Look at this. I want you to see this. This is so wonderful in questions and answers. I read this quotation. He says now, amen. What does the image of the beast mean? So that's why we are going to close with that. It's a joint question to that. And the person who asked this, he asked a good question. And then he says, the Bible clearly teaches that the Catholic Church is the beast. And the Bible said that a beast means a power. Is that right? A beast. The Bible says that the beast meant a power. How many can say amen? And the beast was the Vatican City, the Catholic hierarchy. All right. And now that was the power of the church. That was the beast. And then he says, now, then the Protestant church came out of the Catholic Church and organized themselves. A little power. That is the image. So the image of the beast, let's continue. Then he says, if something was made in my image, we want to explain what is the image of the beast. Brother Branham says, if something was made in my image, it will have to look like me. If something was made in the image of this church, it will have to look like this church. Hallelujah. Can someone say amen? Oh, I'm enjoying. So we are talking about the image of the beast. So the image of the beast must look like the beast, must have the same power, even like the beast. Praise God. And I also want to read something here because before we close, because we heard that there is a mark in the head, there is a mark in the forehead. We want to see what is this mark. How many can say amen? According to Malachi chapter 4, we want to see what Brother Branham says. Amen. What is this mark? Hallelujah. Praise God. Do you love these things? Eh? How many can say amen? What is this mark? Listen to this. In the message, a resume of the ages. Please, hallelujah, hang around. We are closing now. But I just want you to see this. He says here that this ecumenical council will end up with Rome at the head. Eh? Even though the people did not envision it that way. This is so because Revelation 17:3-6, it states that the war, mystery Babylon, is seated on the beast. And then he says, she is controlling the last or fourth empire. We all know that. This Roman Catholic, this Roman church is doing that. with the world church system under, he says, under her, under her. Rome will be controlling. And this image, church system, will be obedient to Rome. Because Rome, listen, oh, I know my friend will enjoy this. He says, he says, Rome, because Rome controls the gold of the world. How many can say amen? Rome controls the world, the gold of the world. He says, thus all the people have to belong to the world church system or be at the mercy of the elements, for they cannot buy or sell without the mark of the beast in the hand or head. Then he says, now, listen now. He says, they cannot buy or sell without the mark of the beast in the hand or head. So we want to know, what is this mark in the head or in the head? Let's continue. This mark, listen now, this mark in the head means that they will have to take the doctrine of the world church system, which is Trinitarianism, etc. And the mark in the hand, which means to do the will of the world church. How many can say amen? Oh, shall I repeat it? We are talking about the mark in the head and in the hand. This mark in the head means, how many can say amen? That they will have to take the doctrine of the world church system, which is Trinitarianism. How many can say amen? Etc. So the mark in the head is taking the doctrine of the world church system, etc. And the mark in the hand, which means to do the will of the world church. Brother, do you see what the mark in the hand and what receiving the mark of the beast is? May God help. It's forfeiting your rights. Hallelujah. And then he says, this image will try to keep the bride. Listen to this. I'm talking about the squeeze. This image will try to keep the bride from preaching and teaching, etc. Do you believe their ministers will be forbidden to give comfort and truth to the people who need it? Do you see, friends? This is serious. It's going to happen in the squeeze. Praise God. But before the Antichrist in person takes over this complete world system of churches, the true church will be taken away from this world to be with the Lord. God will catch away his bride for the great marriage supper of the Lamb. How many can say amen? How many are being blessed? How many can see? You know, people are talking about those chips, what, coronavirus, the chips saying the mark is this and that. The prophet is saying the mark in the hand. How many can say amen? And in the forehead. How many can say amen? Is forfeiting your right. Hallelujah. Joining in the World Council of Churches, the mark in the head means that we will have to take the doctrine of the church world system. Hallelujah. Which is Trinitarianism, etc. And the mark in the hand, which means to do the will of the world church. That's what Malachi 4 is saying. How many can say amen? And we quickly want to go here. I want to show you this. Hallelujah. What is the mark of the beast? Listen, questions and answers. 59:06-28. Paragraph 126. Hallelujah. Are you ready? The prophet says, the mark of the beast is on today. And the seal of God, listen, the seal of God is the Holy Spirit. To reject it is the mark of the beast. So rejecting the Holy Spirit, rejecting the baptism of the Holy Spirit, is receiving the mark of the beast. How many can say amen? Whoever who sees the Holy Ghost, that you are supposed to receive it and don't do it, automatically you take the mark of the beast, because there is only two classes to exist. How many can say amen? Oh, that didn't have the seal of God, had the mark of the beast. So to receive the seal of God is to receive the Holy Ghost. Listen, to reject it is to have the mark of the beast. There is the whole thing. That's exactly right. How many can say amen? Praise God. Listen to this now. Why I say God is training us. How many can say amen? For the rapture. Praise God. I saw he's training us for the squeeze. He says here, remember, there will never be an impersonation on that. It can never. Now, it is in existence. So, Brother Branham was talking about that. In this message, look away to Jesus 63. He said the third bull was in existence. And I also want to say it is also still in existence. How many can say amen? The third bull now is in existence. I am warned of this. Right at this now, he says so. It could just identify its presence among you. See, but it will not be used in a great way until this council begins to tighten up. And when it does, the Pentecostals and so forth can almost impersonate anything, can be done. But when that time comes, when the squeeze comes down, then you will see what you have seen temporarily, hallelujah, being manifested in the fullness of its power. See. So we saw the third bull temporarily. So Brother Branham says, what we saw, Brother Branham creating squirrels, Brother Branham doing this and that, in our time, it's going to be manifested in the fullness of its power. If Brother Branham created a squirrel, we are going to create live cows. We can even create an elephant, because it will be manifested in its fullness. What happened in the days of William Branham was temporal, but this squeeze will be manifested in its full power. How many can say amen? Oh, may God help us. Praise God. And listen to this. May God be with us. Hallelujah. Praise God. I know that God is speaking to us. How many are being blessed? Amen. Praise God. Listen, as I close, there's something which I want to talk. Who is the first person? I want to talk to finish with the image of the beast. So we heard that the image of the beast is something which looks like. If something was made in my image, it has to look like me. And if something is made in the image of this church, it has to look like that church. Listen now, who is the first person? We are talking about beast to be marked in this world. It was Cain. How many can say amen? He was marked by what? The image of the beast. How many can say amen? So watch now. I'm laughing. I'm enjoying now. Who was the father of Cain? Who was the father of Cain? So Cain, his father was the beast. So who was Cain? Cain was not the beast, but he was the image of the beast. How many can say amen? He was speaking like the beast. He exercised the power of the beast. How many can say amen? So do you see that Cain? Let me read this. Let's quickly. Amen. How many can say amen? We are talking about the image. He says here on Ephesians, God does not, the Ephesians church, God does not enter animals, but Satan can and will accomplish his ends. He could not have a child directly by Eve, as did God by Mary. So he entered into the serpent and beguiled Eve. He seduced her, and by her did Satan have a child vicariously. Cain, listen now, Cain bore the full spiritual characteristics of Satan and the animalistic, sensual, fleshly characteristic of the serpent. How many can say amen? No wonder the Holy Spirit said that Cain was that wicked one. He was. So do you see that Cain, how many can say amen, was the image of the beast. He killed. That's why even Jesus, he told those Pharisees, you are like of your father, the devil, who was a murderer. So do you see that Cain was also marked? Are we together? He was the image of the beast. How many can say amen? So I told you that this whole thing is coming to a showdown. Hallelujah. That's why the third bull is connected. How many can say amen? The third pool is connected, hallelujah, to the squeeze, because the third pool will come into full manifestation in the squeeze. Listen, the devil also is becoming flesh. Do you know that the devil starts as an antichrist, then he becomes a false prophet? Go and read in the seals. He says he starts as antichrist, false prophet, and beast. So when it is beast now, it is the devil, Satan incarnate. So even us also, the word is becoming flesh, and the flesh is becoming the word. So it means the Bible says also, listen, hallelujah, as Cain is the image of the beast, the bride is the image of Elohim. How many can say amen? Let us make man in our own image, hallelujah, in our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish, over the birds, over everything. Brother, do you see that these things, hallelujah, how many can say amen? The same time when Jesus Christ came on earth, Judas also came on earth. The same time that Jesus left the earth, Judas also left the earth. The same time when Jesus was hanging on the cross, the same time Judas was also hanging. So it means, how many can say amen? It's coming up, hallelujah, to that great showdown when the devil is manifested in human flesh, and the children of God, how many can say amen, are also manifested in human flesh. Can you see it, friends? When we talk about the third pool, hallelujah, we are back in Eden again. The word is in the bride. The word has been made flesh. How many can say so in the third? That's why Brother Branham says, watch the third pool during that time of the squeeze. Why? If the devil is going to become the beast, and we know that the devil will be in the beast. How many can say amen? The beast there in the water, in the tribulation period, to fight with what? But it's coming up. How many can say amen? I'm just showing the types, that the serpent, how many can say amen? Hey, Cain was the image of the beast, was the image of the serpent. So you and me, we are also told to let us make men in our likeness, in our image. So it means us, the bride, we are the image of Elohim. We are the image of Melchizedek. Because Brother Branham says, out of Elohim, how many can say amen? Out of God came the Logos. How many can say amen? And out of the Logos came men. Brother Branham says, we came from the Logos. And the Logos was also in the image of God. How many can say amen? I don't have, how many can say amen, any things to continue. But I think those who are spiritual can catch it. How many can say amen? May God really bless you. I remember if I left something, I remember when Brother Branham was saying, when he was talking about the marriage and divorce, Brother Branham was saying, hallelujah, I've got notes here. I wish the Holy Spirit can show you what is in my notes. So I also pray that may this Holy Spirit be the after speaker and really make you understand even what I was trying to put across. May God bless you. May we bow our heads. Lord God, the same yesterday, today, and forever, the bright and morning star, we thank you, Lord God Almighty, that you are preparing us, Lord, even for this great time where we are going to be the Word. Because you said, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Lord God Almighty, and that Word was made flesh. Lord God Almighty, as Cain was the image of the serpent, we are made in your likeness, in your image. We are going to speak things into existence. Lord God Almighty, may you give us, Father, that courage, that faith, so that we exercise even the the faith now during the lockdown, so that in the squeeze we will say the same God that delivers us, that delivered us in the lockdown, in the pandemic, how much more shall he deliver us in this great hour when we are squeezed, oh God. But we thank God that we are ready for that. We pray, Lord, that we are going to hold on like Shadrach, Meshach and Abednego. We are not going to forfeit, Father God. We are not going to sell our birthright. We thank you. We appreciate you in the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Hallelujah.